Now welcome to free online tutorial class. This is Olorun Toba. Please do in order to get updates from this channel. Today in this video, I'll be showing us another way to get 50 marks in chemistry WAEC practical. And this is the second episode. You can check the other videos in the channel. Welcome back. Okay, today I'll be showing us how the formulas that we use in calculating any questions involving titration. Majorly, we have about four formulas that we can use to calculate any questions related to titration. Depends on the question. Savannah. And when we say Savannah, Savannah is CA. VA over CB VB is equal to CA molarity. Over we say molarity of acid. Most of the time we use A to represent acid and B to represent base. But it depends on the question. At times, what you are filling into your burette, what you fill into your burette is your A, and that's the table you are going to prepare. And what you pipette is your B. So at times it might not be A and B, it might be C and D, it might be E and F. But whatever thing you fill into your bread is your acid, because we fill acid inside bread and we pipette base with pipette. So we have CA, molarity of acid, which is a mole DMG volume of acid. And that one can be gotten from your tidal value is your VA. Okay, so VA, that's the volume of acid, then VB is the volume of base. Volume of base is constant, is 25 centimeter cube. It's because that's the volume of the pipette, all right? Is equal to NA. NA is the mole ratio of acid. When we say mole ratio, when you write an equation, I will show you a balanced chemical equation on the screen. There, see the balanced chemical equation there. Okay, when you balance an equation, the number in front of those formulas are regarded as the number of moles. That's the stoichiometric number. If you put one in the front of acid, it means that the mole ratio of acid is one. If you put two in front of acid, it means that the mole ratio of acid is two. The same way for base too. So the number of moles of acid and base, that is the NA over NB. So NA is the mole ratio of acid, while NB is the mole ratio of base. Okay, you are welcome back. Now, when you want to use this formula, the first thing you must do if you are using this formula is that you must firstly be able to itemize all those parameters. Which one, the one you were not given, will be the one you will use to make the subject of the formula. Let's say you were not given CA in the question. Alright, that means you have known your VA, you have known your CB, you have known your VB. You can make CA the subject of the formula. Very good. Automatically, you definitely know your NA over NB, because you have to write the chemical equation for such reaction. Alright, so after getting that, the next thing you must do, please take note, the next thing you must do is that all the value, you must firstly insert them into the formula. Before you make anything the subject of the formula, you must firstly insert all the values. Okay, you do not know your CA, the CA was not given. You must firstly supply your VA into the formula, your CB into the formula, your VB into the formula is equal to NA over NB, let's say 1 all over 2. That one alone attracts 1 mark. If you do not supply that, you will miss 1 mark for that equation. It is not about formula, we call it correct substitution. So when you correctly substitute those values into those formula, you hand yourself 1 mark. Then you proceed to making maybe CA the subject of the formula. That one will also earn you 1 mark. Are you with me, my student? Okay, after making CA the subject of the formula that hand you 1 mark, then the final answer. Please take note. This is another rule that you must not forget. When you are calculating your molarity, you must calculate it into three.
Check it out on the screen there.
Three significant figures. That means that most of the time is the concentration of either acid or base will start from 0. So you have 0. Let me say 0.0358. That's the three significant figure. But if after 0, the next value is not zero, it is a real figure like 0.123. That is three significant figure. If you do not make your molarity to be three significant figure, you will lose 1 mark. You will lose 1 mark for that. I hope you understand that. Okay, let's move on. Another formula is the molarity itself, that your CB. It also has a formula. Your CA is equal to mass com over molar mass. Mass com over molar mass. What is mass com? Mass com is expressed in gram per dmq. So whatever mass you were given, if it is not in dmq, you must convert it to dmq. I will show you how to convert ordinary mass to mass com. So that means that mass con is a gram in 1000 centimeter cube. If a gram is given apart from 1000 centimeter cube, you need to convert it. And also, we're going to see how we convert mass con in the box there on the screen. Okay, so you must firstly determine your mass con. Mass con over molar mass. Molar mass of either of the acid or molar mass of the base. So what I'm saying in essence is that your molarity, that is your concentration of acid, is equal to, that's the formula to calculate it, mass con, which is in gram per dmq, over molar mass. Alright? Okay, you are welcome once again. Now, that's another formula. Remember, I've given you two formulas now. Number one is Savannah. CA, VA over CB, VB is equal to NA over NB. Alright, so your CA or your CB can be calculated with the formula molarity is equal to mass con. Percentage purity is mass of pure over mass of impure multiplied by 100. Anything in percentage is in 100. Mass of pure divided by mass of impure multiplied by 100. Mass of pure is that mass you got from calculations like Savannah, like either Savannah or molarity is equal to mass con over molar mass. Any value you get using that formula is a mass of pure. Mass of impure will be given in the equation. You just say mass of pure over impure multiplied by 100. Then percentage impurity to be mass of impure minus mass of pure divided by mass of impure multiplied by 100. Alright, that is how to calculate, or those are the formulas that we use during questions involving problems involving titration.